Hello students, my name is Darshan Sarang. I am working as an assistant professor at SNPIT Umrakh Bardoli, which is in Surat. This is my third lecture for MEBC subject. In previous two lectures, I discussed about units and dimension. In this lecture, I will start with a new chapter, that is basic chemical calculations. So, if I talk about my previous two lectures, I discussed about the various methods of measuring the concentration of the chemicals or the components. In this lecture, I will briefly discuss about the various other methods to represent the composition of the chemicals or components. First three method was the normality, molarity and molality, so which is used to discuss the composition when the solution is made from pure chemical, means when there is a solution of acid in water or base in water, then we can measure its concentration in terms of normality, molarity or molality. So here we will see the other methods. The first one method is weight percent. Before that, we will see that various methods are used to express the composition of mixtures and solutions. The methods given here are explained by considering a system composed of two components. Means we have a system of two components, and those two components are A and B. The same method are used for the systems containing more than two components. So if we have a mixture of more than two components, then also we can use this weight fraction or weight percent method. The composition of the mixture or solution can be expressed in weight percent, volume percent and mole percent. So these three methods we are going to discuss step by step. So first one is the weight percent. So weight percent, meaning of weight percent is, or we can also say it as mass percent. So here we will consider that weight is equal to mass. So mass percent will equal to weight percent. So how to measure or how to calculate the weight percent of component A in the mixture of component A and B? So by definition, it is the weight of any component expressed as percentage of total weight of the system. So for that we need total weight or total mass of all the components. So suppose here we have two components A and B, so we will use the mass of both two components. So to determine weight percent of A, we will calculate first what is the weight of that particular component A, and then we will divide it by the total weight of the system. So here we have two components A and B, so total weight of the system will equal to weight of A plus weight of B, and we are talking about percentage. So we will multiply this ratio with 100. This way we will get the weight percent of A. Now suppose if I want to know what is the weight percent of B, then what will I do? I will simply subtract that weight percent of A from the 100. Why? Because we know that summation of any percent is equal to 100. So if we want to know the weight percent of B, then we can subtract weight percent of A from the 100. So if weight percent of A is equal to suppose 20, then surely weight percent of B will be equal to 80. Here we can see that W is total weight of all the component, and here we have only two components, A and B. So W will be equal to WA plus WB. Suppose we have four component, then it will be WA plus WB plus WC plus WD. So this is how we can calculate weight percent of any component from the mixture. Okay, now we will see what is volume percent. So just like weight percent, we can also calculate volume percent for the mixture of components. Again, if we assume that we have mixture of two components, suppose A and B, then what is the definition? It is the pure component volume of any component expressed as a percentage of the total volume of the system. So volume percentage of A will equal to pure volume, pure component volume of A divided by total volume of system into 100. So why again 100 is here? Because we are talking about percentage, so we will have to multiply it with 100 so that we can get volume percent. So again, VA is volume of component A. V, what is V? V is the total volume, that is the summation of volume of all the components. And here we know that we have only binary system, so we have only two components. So our V will be summation of VA and VB. So the final volume percentage of A will be pure component volume of A divided by total volume of the system into 100. So again, if we have n number of component, then it will be volume of A divided by VA plus VB plus VC plus up to VN. So this way we can calculate volume percent of the mixtures. The next one is mole percent. Mole percent, as we know that we generally calculate chemical composition in terms of moles, not in terms of the mass or the volume. The volume percentage is used when we talk about the gaseous system. So if our mixture of component A and B is in gaseous form, then we can easily use volume percentage. But when it is in liquid form, then generally we use mole percentage. So again, mole percent, how it is defined? So it is the moles of any component expressed as a percentage of total moles of the system. Again, we are considering a binary system which consists of component A and component B. Then mole percentage of A equal to moles of A divided by total moles of all the component multiplied by 100. Suppose we have two component, then total moles will be moles of A plus moles of B. So here this MA is molecular weight of component A, MB is molecular weight of component B. So to calculate mole of A, as we discussed in our previous lectures, moles of A equal to mass of A divided by molecular weight of A, and moles of B equal to mass of B divided by molecular weight of B. So this is something different than other formula. This is how we can determine moles of A. And suppose after calculation we get that mole percentage of A is equal to suppose 25%, then mole percent of B will be equal to 100 minus 25%, that is equal to 75%. So these were the three different types of method which are used to calculate composition of the mixtures. Okay, now comes the mole fraction. Till now we were discussing about the percent, so the answer was something like 20%, 50%, or it may be 100%, but it cannot be greater than 100%. But when we talk about the fraction, we know that fraction is always between 0 to 1. So if we talk about mole percent, volume percent, or mass percent, it can range from 0 to 100%. But when we talk about mole fraction or mass fraction or any type of fraction, then fraction will be always in the range of 0 to 1. Okay, what is the definition of mole fraction? It is the ratio of number of moles of particular component to the total moles of the system. Here again, we will consider that we have a binary system. So it will consist of A and B components. Now to calculate mole fraction of A, we will calculate first the mole of A divided by total mole of system. Now to calculate moles of A, we need mass or weight of A divided by its molecular weight. So this is the formula of moles of A, that is mass of A divided by molecular weight of A. And here it is again moles of A, and here it is moles of B, because in denominator we keep all the components. So we have two components, so we have kept moles of A plus moles of B in denominator. So here this XA is known as mole fraction of A, and XB is known as mole fraction of B. So suppose mole fraction of A is 0.1, then we can say that mole fraction of B equal to 1 minus 0.1, that is equal to 0.9. So here there is a relationship between mole percent of A and mole fraction of A. As we know that percentage are always equal to are always obtained by multiplying 100. So here again 100 is multiplied with mole fraction of A. So this way we can get mole percent of A by using mole fraction of A. And suppose we want to know mole fraction of A from mole percent of A, then we can simply divide mole percent of A by 100. Okay. Okay. Here we will talk about the weight fraction of A. So how we calculate weight fraction? So to calculate weight fraction, first of all, we should have data of all the components, because when we calculate mole fraction, whenever there is a mixture, then only we will calculate the fraction. And if there is no mixture, then there is no need of calculating weight fraction or weight percent.
So weight fraction, it is the ratio of weight of particular component to the weight of a system. So weight of the system is the summation of weight of all the components. So weight fraction of A equal to weight of A divided by total weight of the system. Weight of A is denoted by WA, and total weight is equal to WA plus WB. And as discussed previously, weight percent of A will be equal to weight fraction of A into 100. So till now we discussed almost 5 things. First one was weight percent, second one was volume percent, third one was mole percent, fourth was mole fraction, and fifth is weight fraction. So here we will see one numerical so that we can apply our understandings. Ethanol and water forms a azeotrope containing 96% ethanol by weight. Find the composition of azeotrope by mole percent. So here we have to calculate the composition of azeotrope by mole percent, and we have system of two components. The first component is ethanol and the second component is water, and they are forming some azeotrope. Now what is given? That this mixture contains 96% ethanol by weight. So we have two component, and weight percent of one of the component, that is ethanol, is given, that is 96%. So weight percent of ethanol is given, and he is asking to determine the mole fraction. So from weight fraction we need to find mole percent. So we will convert it, and we will use the molecular weight to convert weight into mole. So by taking basis as 100 kilogram of mixture, so it means we are assuming that we have mixture of 100 kilogram. So 96% ethanol means we have 96 kilogram of ethanol, and rest of the kilogram, that is 4 kilogram, that 4 kilogram is water. Here you can see 96 kilogram ethanol and 4 kilogram water. Now we know that the molecular weight of H2O is 18 and molecular weight of ethanol is 46. So by using this molecular weight, we will simply convert the kilogram into moles. How? So moles can be calculated by dividing the weight or mass with molecular weight. So weight or mass is 96 and molecular weight is 46. So moles will be 2.087 kilomole. Because it is assumed in terms of kilogram, we will get kilomoles. Same way, we can calculate moles of water. How? We will divide the mass of water or weight of the water with the molecular weight of the water, that is 4 divided by 18. So it will be 0.222 kilomole. So now we have determined the kilomoles of individual component. So we will simply add these components and we will get that total moles equal to 2.3 kilomole. And now what we want to identify? Mole percent of azeotrope. So ethanol will be moles of ethanol divided by total moles. So total moles we have 0.222 moles of ethanol is 2.087 and total mole is 2.3. And we want to find percentage, so we will simply multiply it with 100 and we will get mole percent of ethanol equal to 90.38%. And suppose we want to know the mole percent of water, then we will subtract this 90.38 from the 100. This way we will get the mole percent of water. Okay, next example. Again we have nitric acid and water, and it is forming a maximum boiling azeotrope containing 62.2% water by mole. So here mole percent is given, not the weight percent. 62.2 mole percent. And we need to find the composition of azeotrope in terms of weight percent. So in previous example, weight percent were given and mole percent was supposed to find. In this case, mole percent is given and we need to find weight percent. So it is vice versa type case. Again, we will assume that 100 kilomole of mixture is there. So in 100 kilomole mixture, nitric acid and water is there. So by using this 62.2 mole percent, we will get that 62.2 kilomole of water and remaining is nitric acid. So again, we will calculate the molecular weight of nitric acid and water, that is 63 and 18. And by using the molecular weight of both component and moles of the both component, we can find the weight of the individual component. Then we will add and get the total weight of the mixture. And by dividing the individual weight of nitric acid with the total weight, we will get this 68.02% weight percent nitric acid. So suppose if we want to know the weight percent of water, then we will simply subtract this 68.02 from 100, and that will be our weight percent of water. I hope all these calculations are understood to you. Okay, thank you.